Hi, everyone. This is Ed Mabrie with FaithByReason.net.
Hey, Ed and everyone. This is Pastor Jerry Girardo with Lighthouse Christian Church in Novato. Good to see you, brother.
Good to see you, too, Pastor Jerry. Thank you. And we are in, I keep saying this every week, we're in turbulent times, but it's just in levels of magnitude, it just keeps getting more and more tumultuous. Obviously, we have this pandemic, which we haven't seen in the world since the early 1900s, before my grandparents were born. So we have that. We have all the kind of financial issues. And now we have a tumultuous election that we are still dealing with, even though we voted a week ago. There's still questions, even though, you know, one side has claimed victory, the other side has not conceded. So we're going through all that.
Right.
And so you have a message about that, because about the level of anxiety that we're dealing with and what we should do about it. So I just wanted to ask you, what should our position as Christians be, in spite of everything that's going on? What should our attitude be about this election, no matter which way it goes?
Yeah, no, great question. And that was the focus of our message this past Sunday, because as you're saying, it's so tumultuous, and we're going to have to be patient, of course, to find out what the end result is. Many think it's a foregone conclusion, but there are challenges. We just got to wait and see. And while we're waiting, other things are unfolding, and there's going to be change one way or another. We don't know, but there's going to be significant change that's taking place and reactions to that change, which are, we can be preoccupied with everyone's reactions and whether people are going to deal with each other in a healthy way or a really unhealthy way. Right. But one thing I find that's so comforting all the time, and especially when there's a lot of change, is to focus as believers on the most important things that will never change. And the first thing that we talked about in the message was the fact that nothing will ever change who the God of the universe is, and that he's in absolute control of things that are unfolding. He's not only overseeing it, he actually has control. And so we can have trust in him. He's demonstrated his unconditional love to us by sending his son to die for us. He has all power and authority. He can intervene any way he sees fit in his perfect, you know, approach to everything. So we can rest and really take comfort in that. So there's so many scriptures that come to mind that relate to that from the Old Testament and the New Testament. Oh my goodness, what a relief to know that it's actually not men in charge. It's actually God who's ultimately in charge. 2 Chronicles 20, verse 6 says, O Lord God of our fathers, are you not God in heaven? The answer, of course, is yes. You rule over all the kingdoms of the nations. In your hand are power and might, so that none is able to withstand you. It's just this great reminder. And we can remind ourselves every day, who's really in charge? And he's awesome, powerful, benevolent. He has unconditional love for his creation, for us. Wow. The second thing that we touched on was...
Hey, sorry, folks. Had a little bit of technical difficulty there, but we are back. And Pastor Jerry, continue. You were going with your second point.
Yes, thanks, Ed. Sorry about that. But yeah, the second point is that these election results don't change who we are in Christ Jesus.
Right.
How could anything ever change who we are in Christ Jesus? We are in God's kingdom forever, thanks to his son, Jesus Christ. We have eternal life in him. We have new life in him. We have the Holy Spirit abiding within us. These things don't change. And so it gives us the comfort and the strength to know that no matter what happens, no matter what changes take place in life, on any level, personal, in a community, in our nation, in our world, God is still living within us and is going to take care of us and protect us. There's so many great, great things that God tells us about that. You know, Psalm 118 verses 6 and 7 say, the Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do to me? The Lord is on my side as my helper. I shall look in triumph even on those who hate me. Wow, pretty strong words. Yeah. But God living within us has this ability. Philippians 4:19 says, and my God will supply every need of yours according to the riches of his glory in Christ Jesus.
Right.
Now, I'm so glad that Paul not only had the confidence to say that, But to know it was the truth and to share it with us, for goodness sakes, we have everything that we need, no matter the outcome of an election, in our view, good or bad, no matter the pandemic that rages, whatever our personal challenges are. Wow. And the third point is that these election results, whatever they happen to be, don't change what our responsibilities and our opportunities are. They don't change what we're called to do. Whether, no matter who's sitting in the White House or who's sitting in Congress, I'm still called to move forward in Christ Jesus, to serve him, to honor him, to know that I can carry out the Great Commission every day in a variety of ways, simply by following hard after Jesus Christ. So when I stop and think about these inalterable things, nothing's going to change that. It gives me strength. It actually galvanizes me. And I trust it can galvanize all of us to press on with courage, knowing that God is on our side. And more importantly, we've chosen to be on God's side.
That's great. And, you know, it's when I think about it, you know, no matter who's in the White House, we actually live in a different kingdom. We don't, God's kingdom is not a democracy, or actually technically we're a democratic republic. Everyone always calls us right. A democracy. The U.S. is not a democracy. We're a democratic republic. Sorry.
Right.
But the kingdom of God is a monarchy.
Yes.
But
yes.
No one can vote him out, and he's not going to resign.
So, yeah.
But when we were talking about this, it reminded me of a passage that I was just studying recently in Hebrews. I'll read it really quickly. It's from the Hall of Faith, the famous chapter in the book of Hebrews on the Hall of Faith. It says, "These all died in faith," speaking of the members of the Hall of Faith, "not having received the promises, but having seen them and greeted them from afar, and having confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on earth. For that they say such, make it obvious that they are seeking after a country of their own. And indeed, if they had been mindful of that country from which they went out, they would have had an opportunity to return. But now they desire a better country, that is, a heavenly. Therefore, God is not ashamed of them to be called for their God, for he has prepared a city for them." So he's saying that all these faithful people, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Abel, all these folks, they were on earth, but they recognized that they were citizens of a different country, a heavenly country, and so are we. We're temporary residents on earth, but our citizenship is in heaven. So how do you think that should affect how we look at the governments and the situations that we are on in earth? Because we get all embroiled in, we're Democrat, we're Republican, we're this, we're that.
Right.
Are we?
Yeah, no. Fundamentally, in Philippians 3:20 speaks of it. You actually quoted it, but our citizenship is in heaven. We are strangers, just like you just said. We are foreigners here in a sense. Christ even came to this world that he created, and he says the very same thing. If this was his kingdom, then people would be rising up right and left to defend him, even before Pilate, even before others. That's not the situation that we live in here, in this earth, in this season. Someday it will be, looking forward to the future, because Christ is sovereign and has all power and authority throughout the universe. But the truth is, our citizenship is in heaven. And so at times we're going to feel, wait a minute, I'm not in sync with what's going on in the world. How can I be if the world is following after the flesh, if men are following after men instead and women instead of following after Christ and seeing his kingdom come, his will be done on earth as it is in heaven? That's an awesome objective. It hasn't happened yet, even though we are God's instruments chosen by him to carry the gospel message and to share the love and light of Jesus Christ. So again, those things don't change. But yeah, I'm very patriotic. I love our country. I'm blessed to have been born in this country with the advantages and the opportunities, but I love everyone in this world. I want to, I need to, Christ sure does. And we need to continue to understand that this partisanship, it's not such a healthy thing now, is it? We really need to follow after God and find out his values, his principles, follow him. Don't put any leaders on a pedestal, for goodness sakes, but continue to pray for our leaders, no matter who is holding office. And that's scriptural too, from Romans chapter 13 and other places, that we're supposed to support, in a sense, those who are put in place to govern, we have a responsibility to pray for our leaders, whoever they happen to be. And we will do that faithfully.
Well, and that's great, because what you said makes so much sense, because we have to, yes, we're citizens here. We have responsibility to our temporal lives. We have given this earth to take care of. However, we have to put God first. So I'm not a Democrat or Republican first. I'm a child of God first. And then second, yes, I can get involved in this, because you will see a lot of even Christian ministries, which are very partisan, very political, and they get so caught up in the minutia and they get all that anxiety. But you have to take a step back and say, you know, no matter what happens, like you said, no matter whether the candidate I want to win won or whether he doesn't, right, in the big picture, I'm just passing through.
We are, and God is very clear on that, and God's also very clear that he is in control and he's working things out for his purposes. And just because the candidate we think or voted for, who we believe is more in alignment with God's value, doesn't prevail, doesn't mean that God's left the scene. It means he's up to something really important in every season, and he does it in his own perfect way that often surprises us. But he's after, first of all, the souls and the salvation of human beings. And he's going to do whatever it takes to bring that about. So that was the message this week. And I think it just gives us comfort, and it can help stabilize us instead of being, you know, pulled by the winds of change and pushed around. I love feeling anchored to Jesus Christ. No matter what, I can still be at peace because of Christ in my life.
The Bible says in Romans, he works all things together for good, all things. No matter who wants, he'll take whoever wants. And our choice, he gives us that free choice, and he'll take whoever wants, and he'll work it to
the my goodness. Yes, yes. I love that. Oh, Romans 8:28. It's a life verse for me. But thank you, Ed. Yeah,
great. Thank you, Pastor. Great conversation. Why don't you give us a little preview of what you will be discussing what you'll be talking about, this coming Sunday in your upcoming message.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, this Sunday, the Lord's really put it on my heart to bring a key verse from Scripture, which is Jeremiah 29:11, where God says, I know the plans I have for you. They're plans to prosper you. They're plans to give you hope and a future. And interestingly enough, we're going to be looking at that chapter in Jeremiah, because God is speaking to the Israelites in exile when they were going through a dark time because of their own rebellion against God. And finally, he decided he was going to deal with them by disciplining them, but also communicating he hasn't left them, even though things seem dark. And he tells them to continue on with life and honor him and turn back to him. And he has a plan, even when it seems dark, that he is working in our lives to produce that which is great. And so, and this isn't the prosperity gospel. We'll clarify, when he's talking about prosperous, he's talking about spiritually and otherwise. But the truth is, God is overseeing our lives and we can trust in him. So even in this election, some think, oh my goodness, if my candidate didn't win, we're going into a dark time, or we're already in a dark time. Many of us see that there's a real moral slide and other problems. But the truth is, God has this plan for us at all times. He communicated it to the Israelites at a critical moment where he was sending them to be disciplined, and he knew they were going to be in hard times. And that was all for good reason, to bring about a wholesale change and to demonstrate his faithfulness to them, even in the midst of that. So no matter what happens in our election and how this country turns and moves forward, it's a good message for us to remember God has good things in store for us. Doesn't mean it's going to be easy, but it's going to be spiritually prosperous for us. And we're so thankful for that.
That's amazing. I look forward to talking to you about it next week. So for everyone watching, please make sure you go to LighthouseChurchNovato.com. There is just tons of great information there. All the messages are there. Subscribe here to this YouTube channel. Hit the subscription button. Hit the notification bell, so you'll see these messages as soon as they come up. You'll see all of the messages throughout the week that go up on the YouTube site. And we will talk to you next week, Jerry, when we discuss that amazing message. I'm really looking forward to it.
Awesome. Thanks, Ed. Really appreciate it. All our love to you, your family, everyone tuning in. And yes, Christ, peace be with all of us. And it can be. And we're so thankful for that. Love you, brother. God bless you.
All right. God bless you too.